there was a bright spot in the media this week. NBC's Savannah Guthrie suggested that Russia was actually responsible for getting Trump elected. And former Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice put her in her right place.
When you look at the 2016 election and you look at it, how relatively speaking it was decided by a handful of votes in a few states, do you think it's possible that Russia's election interference actually worked? It actually elected Donald Trump over Hillary Clinton?
I don't think there is any evidence of that. And, you know, I really don't think that that's a good conversation to have. Mm. I think that really does devalue the people in Wisconsin and Michigan and others who decided to vote for President Trump. But whether you like this president or not, whether you believe that he should have been president or not, let's give the credit to the Americans who went out and voted for somebody who they thought would bring change.
Y'all, it has been 2 years, over 2 years actually. The Mueller report has been released. They found no evidence that the Trump campaign colluded with Russia. We already know from the intelligence community that Russia meddled in the election through basically Facebook ads, memes, social media. They didn't change any votes. There was no hacking of voting machines. There was no change to the vote tally. And yet still we have an ostensibly objective news anchor suggesting that Russians elected Donald Trump. And I think Condoleezza Rice pointed out perfectly here that that is an insult to the millions of Americans who voted for this president and all of the people in rural areas, blue-collar voters, who felt ignored in the previous election and by Hillary Clinton, and basically voted in protest of that with the expectation that Donald Trump was actually addressing their real concerns. And if, you know what, this is actually a good thing for the Republicans, though, that Savannah Guthrie thinks this, because if this is how the media and the Democrats are going to continue to talk about the 2016 election as if this was some foreign uprising against the U.S. and not what it actually was, which was a number of Americans who felt that they had not been heard in politics, telling people that they wanted their concerns talked about. If the Democrats think that, and if that's their messaging, then they're going to ignore those voters again in 2020, and Trump will again have an easy path to victory by appealing to those people who for so long have felt forgotten. But perhaps the biggest story this week, at least one that I personally was involved in, was CNN claiming that a CIA spy was pulled out of Russia because of concerns that Donald Trump mishandles classified information. This story was broken by CNN's Jim Sciutto, who is a news anchor, who also previously worked in the Obama administration, very conveniently, and in fact worked in foreign affairs. So this is really sketchy that he was allowed to write this article in the first place. But he claimed that this spy was a CIA asset working in Russia. He was apparently close enough to Russian President Vladimir Putin that he could actually take pictures of documents on the president's desk. Now, Jim Sciutto claimed that this spy was pulled out of Russia because the intelligence community in the United States was concerned that Trump would accidentally expose this person, putting him at risk. So the spy was pulled out in 2017, obviously about a year after Trump took office. But then the New York Times and the Washington Post confirmed the fact that the spy was pulled out of Russia in 2017, but had numerous sources telling them that it was not because of Trump. In fact, the spy was offered to be pulled from Russia back in 2016 because of the fact that apparently the media was asking too many questions about Russian election interference and was concerned that the media, not Trump, would expose this person's identity. And apparently the media found out about this spy because of leaks from the intelligence community. So apparently it was actually Obama's administration that burned this source, and the spy was offered to be removed then, but declined to do so, and then was offered again in 2017 and said yes, I will come home. He's now apparently living in DC under his real name. CNN has declined to retract their story or update it at all, only saying that they stand by their reporting. And Jim Sciutto has tried to justify this over and over again by pointing out that Trump apparently leaked classified information to Vladimir Putin during a one-on-one meeting, and that was why people were concerned about his handling of classified information. But that apparently was not the reason that the spy was pulled out. That it might be true that Trump mishandled classified information once, but we know in this particular case it had nothing to do with this spy because he was offered to be pulled out of Russia much earlier. So I wanted to find out more about this story, and particularly what the government had to say about it. So we had a briefing this week with Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, and I asked him point blank, which administration burned this source, and is there an investigation into who leaked this to the press?
There were reports this week that the CIA had to pull a top Russian asset out because of concerns that his identity could be exposed. Under which administration was this source burned, and is there currently an investigation into how his identity got leaked to the media?
Yeah, I've seen that reporting. The reporting is materially inaccurate. And you should know, as a former CIA director, I don't talk about things like this very often. It is only the occasions when there's something that I think puts people at risk, or the reporting is so egregious as to create enormous risk to the United States of America, that I even comment in the way that I just did. And I won't say anything more about it. I know the CIA put out a statement. Suffice to say that the reporting there is factually wrong.
So that's pretty much as unequivocal as you can get, that this story is apparently bunk from Secretary Pompeo. And in fact, he even says in that answer that he doesn't usually comment on stories like this because it would be inappropriate, but that he feels the reporting is so inaccurate that he has to set the record straight. Now, interestingly enough, the media, of course, was complaining about the fact that Trump apparently put this spy at risk, but then you turn around and you have other media outlets like NBC finding out where this spy lives in DC and traipsing across his lawn and apparently knocking on his door. So if anyone exposed this guy, it was obviously the media, but news outlets are still peddling CNN's story despite the fact that it's been contradicted and challenged by the government numerous times. For example, Business Insider was one of the outlets that shared this story and then later updated to include some of the information from the New York Times, but didn't say that Sciutto's reporting had been debunked. Vox, Esquire, and Washington Post opinions also ran with the CNN report, despite the New York Times having this key contradictory point that the spy was pulled out or offered to be pulled out under the Obama administration and not after Trump took office. So what you see here is a classic example of how the media breaks a false story and makes its way throughout the media ecosystem. And even when it's challenged by responsible journalists, they refuse to update or challenge the story at all because it's already out there to the public. It's too late at this point. Once they've sent the information out, people believe it. And then once they even try to go back to correct, you always see that the corrections get far less attention than the original bombshell story. But this is par for the course for CNN. They still haven't corrected their Trump Tower story, which was also authored by Jim Sciutto. And isn't it strange how a former Obama official failed to mention in his story that the spy had been offered to be pulled out of Russia during the Obama administration? Seems a little fishy, doesn't it?